there. Well, it's too windy and rainy to use the gardens today to paint as I was going to do. So we're going to use the glass house at last, which is what it was built for, apart from growing all these lovely vegetables and tomatoes. I'm going to do a scene here, just around the little fish pond, some of the lilies and the plants, tropical, subtropical plants growing in the background, an oil for you. So I've made myself a nice little cosy place here, we're in the warm, we're in the dry. The light's a bit dull because it's very grey today, so that'll be a problem with trying to make the various greens and lights and darks, which is going to be a bit dull on the painting. But I think we're still having some fun in here, it's a lovely atmosphere. Oils, and a straight bit of hardwood again. Now the scene we're going to do is going to be through that way, I'll show it in a moment. We've got a standard set of oil paints here, all the colours I can possibly need. And a bit of comfort.
So the scene I'm going to paint then is this with a little watering can through here. A little pathway that goes from the rushes in the pond here. And then the flowers just coming through in the background right up. And to these sunflowers here. You can hear the wind and the rain now and why I'm indoors.
Okay, the first thing I want to do is to work at my composition here. So I'm going to hold my hands up like that in horror. Now I'm going to hold my hands up like that and just take in the composition within that rectangle and imagine where the halfways and quarters are to go onto here. Take a little bit of ultramarine blue, nice colour to see easily. Thin it down with the terps and draw with the brush. Bundle of brushes today for this job, various different sizes. We start with the larger ones to get the background in. Looking at this painting, I'm going to start with the larger one I've got here, which is a filbert, a nice nylon filbert. I like those rounded ends because I've got more control with them. We're going to whack in all of these basic background colours and flick in the basic different tones and variations of the greens. A little bit of sunlight coming out now, that's what we need, isn't it? So before I zoom into the painting, I've got a bit of sunlight. Put some terps on the brush, and let's look at our mid-tones, and the mid-tones in this case are pretty much the windows and skylights, and I want to push the colours, I do want to continue pushing colour. Now white is a body colour, white is a filling colour. Well, it's lovely with the light out, a little bit too hot, I'm not careful. I'm going to put a little bit of cerulean blue into that, I'm going to put a little bit of purple, a little bit of pink into that. I'm going to take a fraction, a touch actually, of alizarin crimson there, and look at that colour here. Here we go, a nice purpley blue look. And it might seem a bit dark at the moment, but when we get the other colours in against it, it'll make sense, because we don't forget we've got the lighter colours of the sunflowers and things to paint in here, and they've got to show against that colour. So, you know, if you want something light to show against it, we've got to have dark. Warm against cool, light against dark, and rough against smooth. So these things are very important. Keep mixing it up. Plenty of paint. Can't have enough. With oil paint, we really enjoy it. And there's a mixture of colours going on here. I mean, I've got my cerulean blue and alizarin and white at the moment, but also there's quite a bit of cream going on. It's going to be shining through between here. A bit more white. A bit more body colour to slap onto here to make the board disappear. Just leaving my line showing slightly so I know where things are coming. I'm going over them slightly as well. We don't want halos. Do not leave a halo of colour around anything. And I want slightly broken colour as well, so I'm going to come back in with some cream in a minute over this. just leaving some of these marks to show where I need to be later. I think at this stage you need to come closer to the painting, so I'm going to zoom in a bit. It's going to get rather hot in here. I know it's, at the moment it's difficult because the painting is quite small within the frame of the, being a vertical one, being a portrait size. But I'll do what I can to show you as I build up these background colours. Now this colour here, which is a strange sort of bluey-greeny colour again, let's get it in just a thin wash of the paint and terps at first. We can use the board very nicely like this for this job, because it soaks in that paint quite quickly. And it's rather a nice effect to use. Come to a smaller brush later. Let's get that just covered for the minute. Get rid of this hardboard and get the effects of light going. Use the edge of the brush, look to it, to tickle leaves in. I don't have to use a small brush straight away, we can work with quite a large brush to begin with. And we're starting to get some of the first of the brighter colours going on. And you see how they work against the warmer, a bit darker this side, a bit more cadmium yellow rather than the chrome yellow there. Let me go back to the cadmium yellow again. The light's coming on and off, it's very difficult when the sun's going in and out. You're painting lights and darks 1 minute, they change the next. Let's bring some texturing onto the seeds. Now the opposite to yellow in the colour circle is purple. So if I take a little bit of purple now, just come back around the outside edges here, should start to make these yellows sing a bit. But not just purple, but if I go to a little bit of alizarin as well, which is slightly redder, you should get a nice effect of the darks going on in the centre. Then we can come down to the deeper greens. We're just starting towards our deeper greens now. We've done the mid-tones, we've done some of the lights. Now the stronger the sunlight, then the stronger the shadows we're going to have in our painting. So I'm not making these shadows too strong at the moment, just a little bit of light. Take it out with your finger, as easy as that. Go to another filbert again. This is number 6 filbert, Mr. Filbert. We'll start to try and find some of these colours going on in the umbrella a little more. So we're using quite a glazing way of painting, painting thin paint over this. Now down here we've got some quite nice French marigolds coming in. I'm going to use a much cooler yellow, a lemon yellow, and then come into that with a slightly warmer one. I've got a bit of sunlight out again, so while it's out, I can see some colour I need to be looking at. The shadows, warms and cools, on the gravel. It isn't until the sun's out that I can actually see these colours. It's very dark in between, so we need to make some dark hues in Prussian blue and a little sienna, which will really give us our darks back into there and make these things stand out again. And you can see now we're getting the light tones and mid tones behind, and as I put these darker ones in, they start to make sense and they will go paler because we've got the light next to the dark and the warm next to the cool and the rough next to the smooth. It'll all gradually build up. So we're now working the mid-tones, warms against cools, lights against darks, and feeling these lovely colours that we can mix as we go along. And then the warmer, in this case a very light bluey green. Just catching the light. Pinkier colour there, down here. That painted as simply as that. I don't want to go into too much detail. The rusty bits going on here. Thank you. pretty much my number four round now, because I need to do a few more leafy pointy shapes. And just pick out some of these petals and leaves, because now we're coming down to the fine details, and this is why I say we can get tighter and tighter, and we finish where we want, where we feel it's correct. Sun, but rain stopped, so we're coming out from the greenhouse. We're going to have a go here in the flower garden. What we want to do first is get all these tones, background tones, worked out very, very quickly. So I'm going to make some very rapid mid greens and so on for the background, park against the lights, so that I can get my painting done as quickly as possible. Very rapid way of working this.